Ask, tell, ask is a communication strategy that we can use to make sure that patients understand their care. We begin by asking patients because it helps to reveal obstacles that they may face when they care for themselves. Without asking, we can't identify these barriers. But when we do know these barriers, we can work with patients to identify solutions. Simply telling patients what to do can lead to frustration. They may shut down and they may agree to a plan that they don't want to do or don't believe in. So working with patients to engage them in their care and help create a plan with them is going to lead to better health outcomes. For example, during my family medicine rotation, I cared for a patient with uncontrolled asthma. 2 weeks earlier, his doctor had started him on a long-acting steroid inhaler. But when I saw him in clinic, he shared that he hadn't begun the inhaler. I asked him, "Why haven't you started your medication, sir?" And he explained to me that he was actually homeless and couldn't afford rent, much less any medications. And without asking that question, I may not have uncovered this major obstacle in this patient's life. So I worked with him and the social worker to set him up with a homeless shelter and also find out a way to pay for his medications. You could begin by asking a patient with diabetes, "What is hemoglobin A1C? If the patient doesn't know, you can explain. And then to confirm that they understood, you can ask again, "Can you tell me what you've learned?" So now let's pause here to turn to some basic medical facts that you may need to know before you begin health coaching. Please be aware that you will learn a great deal about diabetes, hypertension, hypercholesterolemia, and a whole host of other conditions in the months and years ahead. Of course, for some of you, this is information that you have heard before, while for most, this may be completely new. We all come to medical school with different backgrounds. However, these few items represent a very simple but essential place to start before you begin health coaching with patients. With this information, as well as the knowledge that you are currently learning in your other core classes, you can use Ask, Tell, Ask when you counsel patients. Additional materials are available to provide you with more detailed information about these benchmark values, as well as resources you can use with patients to help them understand their medical conditions and goals.
Let's move on to the patient visit. Setting the agenda assures that both the patient's and the clinician's concerns are addressed. As we've heard previously, in many cases, the patient's concerns haven't been adequately addressed. But if we start from the beginning by setting the agenda, we can avoid this common mistake. Depending on the clinical setting in which you work, the person who sets the agenda will differ. It may be a trained health coach, it may be a medical assistant, or a nurse. As a medical student, you may be in an excellent position to set the agenda because you will often be seeing the patient prior to being seen by the supervising physician. These are the steps that you can use when you're trying to set the agenda for a visit. To begin with, ask the patient what he or she would like to discuss. Then, confirm that's what the patient wants to discuss and ask for more agenda items. Tell the patient what you want to discuss, and finally, ask the patient if it's okay to talk about their concerns and then your concerns. Let's see a video clip of how to set the agenda.
Setting the agenda before a visit begins helps address both the patient's and the clinician's concerns. Watch as the health coach, Adriana, only talks about what the clinician wants to talk about and doesn't ask the patient about his concerns.
Hi, Stan. How are you doing today?
Not so good.
Let's see here. You were supposed to get your labs, but you didn't. And Dr. Lopez wanted to talk to you today about your hemoglobin A1C, but without your labs, she's not going to be able to know how your diabetes is doing.
Yeah, my ankle's swollen. It's really hurting. I can hardly walk. It's 6 blocks away. I had enough trouble getting here, and this is only 1 block away, and I just can't do it. It's too painful.
Well, Dr. Lopez will talk to you.
Oh, and I also have the headache, and that's just adding to it because that hurts too.
All right. So Dr. Lopez will talk to you about your headache and your ankle, but it's really important that you get your labs done. So after your visit, I'll give you another lab slip so you could go get your labs done today. So let's talk about your medications now.
Okay.
The health coach did a poor job of setting the agenda. Now watch as Adriana, the health coach, asks the patient what he wants to talk about first. Then she asks him if it is okay to talk about the clinician's concerns.
Hi,
Hi, Stan. How are you doing today? I'm glad to see you.
I'm not doing well. I'm not doing well. I'm in too much pain.
Right. Sounds like you have some stuff on your mind. So what do you want to talk about today?
Yes, I have a swollen ankle. It's 6 blocks to come here. I couldn't catch a bus. I looked for one, but bus wasn't coming, so I had to walk. Ankle was already swollen. Now it's probably swollen more. And I mean, real pain, and I probably need to have an X-ray. I need to talk to somebody about it. I really do.
Yeah, that sounds very uncomfortable.
Oh, and I also have, I was at the hospital. I had a cancerous nodule removed, and haven't been able to, I like to sleep on my side, but can't do that, so I haven't been able to sleep for the last 2 or 3 nights, and I have a splitting headache, and I'm not doing well.
Okay, well, I'm really glad you made it to your appointment. It sounds like you made a big effort to be here, so we really appreciate that. So what I'm hearing you say is that you have a swollen ankle, you have a headache, and you want Dr. Lopez to look at your surgery today?
Yes, I really appreciate that. Somebody has to look in, plus, as I said, also my ankle, and see if that needs to be x-rayed.
All right. So is it okay after we talk about your concerns to talk about your diabetes a little bit?
Oh, yeah, after we do those, yeah, that would be fine.
That
sure.
would be okay with
yeah,
you?
That's fine. Thank
All
you.
Right. So let's talk about your ankle a little bit more.